You're trying your hardest, and that's enough. Welcome to another Dis or Data. Did you like that? The new sound effect? It's the sound that Data Leap is always getting better, more refreshing, and you can tap that appreciation like button down below for more minor improvements. If you want to be a data scientist and make a six-figure starting salary this year, then follow along with Data Leap and let us help you bring data science down to earth. As many of you know, SQL is the place to start when moving into data analytics. Or is it? If you read the title of this video, you'd know that there is often the challenger to SQL, the analysis dark knight, the manipulation ninja in the shadows, the insane data frame in the membrane, pandas. Yes, in today's Dis or Data, we are pitting these two juggernauts of data parsing against each other. In the orange corner, we have SQL. It's the structured query language used for storing, manipulating, and retrieving data in relational databases. Check out the video I made praising its many laurels up in the top right corner. And yes, you can touch your screen. SQL is a big industry accepted tool that will net you about almost any job, excelling in inserting and updating, but putting up some barriers when it comes to hacking yourself without a data frame already created. Companies out there usually pay for a database such as Amazon Redshift, Snowflake, Teradata Vantage, and Oracle Exadata. Then SQL is used to interact with those existing databases. In the black and white corner, Pandas is a free library in free Python that is free. Its name comes from the term panel data, an econometrics term for the data sets that include observations over multiple time periods for the same individuals. Pandas removes the need to create a data structure for your data ahead of time, and it allows you to cleanly write your code to reproducible effect. We'll cover importing data, select, where, insert, and the update commands in SQL today, and their counterparts in Pandas, so you can decide for yourself whether you, a savvy lifelong learner, would prefer the merits in Dis or Data. Hi, it's Andrew from Data Leap, panning to the other camera to tell you that I'm gonna start uploading 3 videos a week for you. After deciding that the quarantine 30-day challenge is not gonna work out for me because it's gonna cause me great anxiety and wouldn't be fair for you for the video quality. Anyway, back to this camera. Thanks, Andrew.
Importing!
Since we need to create a data structure in order to import data in SQL, Pandas is the clear winner in the category. In SQL, we need to use the create table statement, and here is the double headache. Not only do we need to decide what your data fields are named, we also need to know their data types ahead of time. Hold on, we're still not done. We only created the wrapper for the candy to softly fall into. Since our data is starting out as a CSV, it's often the case when data scientists receive from the data engineering team some data, so we need to use the copy command to finally finish the importing step. Now, this gives you more customization in the table's rigidity and becomes a necessary step in creating tables to store specific data like email addresses or phone numbers that have to follow a specific pattern in order to be valid. For that, we'll give SQL a C for could be more convoluted. On the other hand, Pandas cuts down the middleman and creates an object called a data frame in just one line of Python. No questions, no fuss, just a single read CSV method and let Uncle Pandas take care of the rest. That's why Pandas gets an A for a little suspiciously easy. Hey, it's Andrew from Data Leap again, panning to the other camera to ask you if you're enjoying the new grading system. If you do, it would mean a lot to me, a Silicon Valley working professional talking to himself in this room, to smash the heck out of the like button and watch this video to the very end. All right, now back to the camera.
Select!
The select statement is where SQL shines. When we need to fetch records from a table, select statement. Select star from a table is the generic syntax, but make sure to slap a top or limit keyword to restrict the number of rows. You can also select each table name individually. This makes me want to give SQL an A for able and willing, but Pandas, on the other hand, it's even simpler. The head method takes the first 5 rows from the data frame, and you can note how many rows you need with a number between those parentheses. By default, it's 5. The tail method is the same, except for the bottom 5 rows, and that's something that SQL cannot do so easily. For that, we're going to give Pandas an A for a smidge simpler than SQL. Seamless transition.
Wear!
Just like the masks that filter our stinky human breaths, a wear clause is used to filter records based on a condition. Now this is where I can go on about conditional and logical operators and their roles as filtering conditions, but let's keep it simple. In both SQL and Python, you can apply a conditional expressions using comparisons such as less than 3 or greater than 3 or not equal to 3 or less than or equal to 3 or logical operators such as or, and, not. Does that make sense? You can also use logical operators such as or, and, not, and Pandas equivalent jargon pipe, ampersand, and tilde. In Pandas, you choose whether you want to filter Boolean or positional indexing, which comes with better control over filtering specificity and runtime. But this tends to be a much more complicated set of close open parentheses and brackets. I'm gonna give the where statement in SQL an A for a more readable syntax and give Pandas a B for better luck next Python version.
Insert!
Hey, I heard you like data, so I put more data in your data. I'm dating myself with this meme, but you get the idea. We sometimes need to insert into an existing table or data frame. In SQL, the insert statement gets the trick done, but once again, it requires you to name the fields you want to insert manually, not manually. Manually, by yourself. In Pandas, the concat or append methods allow you to insert data from other data frames or dictionaries. It's just more streamlined. However, it could be argued that SQL makes the insert statement more readable and obvious. Well, SQL, you get a B here for boring to write out by hand, and Pandas, you get a B for barely can read what's happening here. This is probably my first hot take, and it's a good opportunity for you to comment down below if you agree or disagree.
Update!
Sometimes things change. Your address, your phone number, your relationship status.
They ask you how you are and you just have to say that you're...
But you can't just hide behind those changes. You need to update them. SQL once again has a readable, intuitive syntax for this kind of maneuver. Update whichever table name, set whichever field, and add conditions so that you can precisely change the email address of one particular customer ID, for example. In Pandas, this is not so straightforward. Well, it's still simple, but there's no specific update command or method. All you do is locate the modification using the methods we talked about in the where section of this video. And then you can assign it to a new value a la Python variable assignment. Hey, probably a good time to talk about positional and Boolean indexing. In Pandas, a series of trues and falses, Booleans, are created whenever you filter a data frame such as the syntax below. This creates a mask of the entire data frame called a Boolean mask, and that calculates the logical condition you present to each value in order to filter the data. Meanwhile, positional indexing focuses on location rather than scanning through your entire data with a Boolean mask. And so here are the options. Lock works only on index, iLock works only on position, add gets scalar values and it's a very fast lock, iAdd also gets scalar values and it's a very fast iLock. If this was confusing, leave a comment down below so I can go through with more vernacular. But this kind of granularity in customizing a given filter's search complexity is the power of Pandas and Python. So you be the judge this time. I'll wait. That's what I would have said too. Hi, future editing Andrew here. Just wanted to say that this video has a lot of self-promotion, but in order to become a community, we really have to give. So I want to take this opportunity to say thank you for coming this far. If there's anything I can do for you, ask, right? A follow on Twitter, a code review, a big tap on Instagram. Let me know how I can support you so we can start a community. And write down in the comments whether or not you think this is a new format and whether you like it. All right, now let's get to drumroll. The results. Okay, so finally here are the grades for this edition of Dis or Data. Did you bet correctly? If not, redeem yourself by pressing the subscribe button, and if so, darn it, you win this time. Catch me on all these social media, Twitter, Instagram, it's all Data Leap Tech, not that convoluted. This is part one of the Pandas versus SQL debate, and I'm glad you guys are here for the fight. If you want to continue fighting down below, comment down below about what parts of the language, either runtime complexity, either different requirements for different systems, either different requirements or different positions that you want to know about Pandas versus SQL, and I will include them in part two, which is coming out very soon. Once again, Data Leap here. Peace.
Select!
The select statement is where the SQL